क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 सेकंड पार्ट. आफ्टर ड्रिंकिंग वाटर ही वांट्स टू गो बैक. फॉर दिस ही जंप्स 4 स्टेप्स अप एंड देन जंप्स 2 स्टेप्स डाउन इन एवरी मूव. इन हाउ मेनी जंप्स विल ही रीच बैक टू द टॉप स्टेप. नाउ द आंसर फॉर दिस, द मंकी इज ऑन द 9th स्टेप. हियर द कंडीशन इज 4 स्टेप्स डाउन इट विल गो एंड 2 स्टेप्स इट विल गो अप. So, in the first jump, it will come to the, from the 9th step, it goes to the 4 steps up it is going. So, it is 9 minus 4, it will become 5th step. The second jump, what it will go from the 5th step, it will go 2 steps down. So, 5 plus 2, it will become 7th step. Then, the third jump, from the 7th step, again it goes to the 3rd step. That means 7 minus 4 steps it will go. So, 7 minus 4, it will become the 3rd step. From the 3rd step, again it has to go down 2. So, 3 plus 2, 5th step. From the 5th step, again it will go back up. So, it will be 5 minus 4, it will become 1st step. So, the monkey reaches the 1st step in 5 jumps. Third one, if the number of steps moved down is represented by the negative integer and the number of steps moved up by the positive integer, represent the moves in part 1 and part 2 by comparing the following. So, first question we have done it. In that one, for the steps down, it is minus 3. So, minus 3, when it is going up, it is plus 2. So, like that, when you have made it 11 jumps, you are getting it minus 8. The second one, 4 steps down and 2 steps up. So, it is getting 8. When you add all these jumps, we have got it 8. So, in A, the sum minus 8 represented going down by 8 steps. So, what will be the sum 8 in B represent? So, answer for the third one is, the number of steps moved down is represented by negative integers. So, first question, the monkey jumps 3 steps down, so it will represent by minus 3. Then, and the number of steps moved up is represented by the positive integer. So, in the first question it was, the number of steps moved up is 2. 2 steps it moved up, that is plus 2. So, for the first one, the monkey moves in part 1 is 3 steps down, so minus 3, and 2 steps up is plus 2. Like that, it made 11 jumps. So, it is 11 times if you have written this. So, all the 3's when you are multiplying, 6 times this 3 is there. So, minus 3 multiplied by 6 will come minus 18. And 2 is of 5 times. So, 5 2's are 10. So, minus 18 plus 10, it will become minus 8. The next one is the second one, B. The monkey moves in part 2R. So, first it has gone up. So, it is plus 4 minus 2. Then plus 4 minus 2. It made it 5 jumps. So, it is 4, 3 times is there. So, 4 3's are 12 and 2 is of 2 times. So, 2 2's are 4 minus 4. 12 minus 4 is 8. So, in A, the sum minus 8 represents going down 8 steps. In B, the sum 8 will represent going up by 8 steps. Now, we'll go for the properties of addition and subtraction of integers. So, first property is the closure under addition. So, the sum of two integers is an integer. That is, any two integer, when you add it, whatever the sum, whatever the answer you are getting, that is also an integer. Example is, 12 is one integer, 13 is another integer. So, these both are the positive integers. When two integers are added, you are getting the answer 25. 25 is also an integer. Now, closure under subtraction. The difference of two integers is also an integer. Here I have taken an example, 7 minus 5 equal to 2. So, 7 is an integer, minus 5 is an integer. So, 2 is also an integer. The next property is commutative property of addition and subtraction. The sum of integers added in any order is the same. So, your answer is, here I have given an example, minus 5 plus 6 is 1. 6 minus 5 equal to 1. Also, if you change the order, 6 plus of minus 5 equal to also 1. So, both the answers we are getting the same. Now, we will go for the subtraction. Subtraction is not commutative for integers. Here, example, 5 minus 3 is 2. You are getting the positive number. Whereas, when you change the order, 3 minus 5, you are getting minus 2. So both the difference are the same. Therefore, subtraction is not commutative for integers. Associative property for integers. Here, addition. Addition is associative for integers. Example is 6 plus of minus 2 plus 2 equal to 6 plus of minus 2. 6 minus 2 is 4. 4 plus 2 equal to 6. The another way we grouped it, 6 plus of minus 2 plus 2. Minus 2 and plus 2 will become 0. So 6 plus 0 equal to 6. Therefore, both the sides, in any way when you group these integers, you will get the addition, we will get the sum as the same. Therefore, addition is associative for integers. Additive identity. 0 is the additive inverse of for the integers. Example is 5 plus 0 equal to 5 and minus 5 plus 0 equal to minus 5. Now we will go for exercise 1.2. Write down a pair of integers whose sum is minus 7. So that means two integers in between addition symbol should be there. So that is the sum. So a pair of integers whose sum is minus 7 can be minus 4 and minus 3. It may be of any other number also. Okay, minus 2, minus 5 also, any numbers. So minus 4 and minus 3 as minus 4 plus of minus 3 equal to minus 7. The second one is the difference is minus 10. A pair of integers whose difference is minus 10 can be minus 7 and 3. So as minus 7 minus 3 it will become minus 10. This also can be of any number. The next one is sum is 0. A pair of integer whose sum is 0 can be minus 10 and plus 10. So minus 10 plus 10 is equal to 0. So this also can be of any number. Minus 50 plus 50, minus 100 plus 100, any number we can write. So yeah, their sum will become 0. Question number 2a. Write a pair of negative integers whose difference gives 8. Here, two integers must be the negative integer and their difference, and that also it should be subtract. Then that gives us the number 8. So a pair of negative integers whose difference is 8 can be minus 3 and minus 11. So minus 3, this is a subtraction symbol, and minus 11. So minus and minus will become plus. So minus 3 plus 11 will become 8. Now B, write a negative integer and a positive integer whose sum is minus 5. So here one should be the negative integer, another should be the positive integer, and they are sum. So in between the positive and the negative integer there should be the plus sign. So a pair of negative integer and a positive integer whose sum is minus 5 can be minus 9 and 4. So minus 9 plus 4 will become minus 5. Second C, write a negative integer and a positive integer whose difference is minus 3. So one will be the negative integer and other is a positive integer, and in between these two integers there should be a subtraction symbol minus. So a negative integer and a positive integer whose difference is minus 3 can be minus 1 and plus 2. Minus 1 is the negative integer, 2 is the positive integer. So minus 1, minus 2, minus and minus will become plus. So 2 plus 1, 3. The bigger number is 2 and the symbol before is minus, therefore minus 3. Question number 3. In a quiz, team A scores minus 40, 10, 0 and team B scored 10, 0 and minus 40 in 3 successive rounds. Successive means immediately one after another. Okay. Which team scored more? Can we say that we can add integers in any order? Now question 3 answer is the total score of team A in the 3 successive rounds are minus 40 plus 10 plus 0, you will be getting minus 30. The total score of team B in the 3 successive rounds are 10 plus 0 plus of minus 40. Minus 40 plus 10 will become minus 30. So the total score of both the teams is minus 30. So they scored the equal points. The last one is we can say that integers can be added in any order. Now fill in the blanks to make the following statements true. First one is minus 5 plus of minus 8 equal to minus 8 plus dash. So here you will get minus 5 because we are the property used is commutative property. Second one, minus 53 plus dash equal to minus 53. The answer is 0. We are using additive identity. Third one is 17 plus dash equal to 0. The answer is minus 17. That is additive inverse. Now question number 4. 13 plus of minus 12 plus dash equal to 13 plus of minus 12 plus of minus 7. So the answer is minus 7. The property used is associative. Fifth one, minus 4 plus 15 plus of minus 3 equal to minus 14 plus 15 plus dash. The answer is minus 3. The property used is associative.